You should know better than to threaten me. Now, what exactly is it that you have on me, Maya?
Is she going to fall?
Please. See, I told you he'd bring her here.
Still, he can't kill her. Everyone knows he bailed her out.
I beg you, don't kill me, too.
This isn't murder, Maya. It's suicide.
Oh my God. We're gonna freeze or
close. Walter can't stand the fact that he's getting older. He's like paranoid about it. He does everything he can to pretend it's not happening, like lift, Botox, implants. He even has a manicurist come over every night to keep his nails neat and trim. Like that does any good.
You can make him think he's seeing a ghost.
Where are you going with this?
I'm going to the Demon of Fear.
You want us to conjure Barbas? Are you out of your mind after everything he did?
I want him back, but not like this.
I'm not suggesting that you conjure him. I'm just suggesting you think of him as some sort of inspiration.
Like, this guy really gives me the... He really gives me this feeling of wearing, like, a mask out of human flesh. Ugh.
I can usually tell how old someone is just by looking at the lines on their hands. Go ahead, see for yourself.
What are you talking about? What?
Is something wrong?
What's the matter, old man? Seeing a ghost? Because you killed me, just like you killed Curtis?
No. It's not possible. It's a
nightmare? One you won't ever wake up from? Guilt's a terrible thing, Walter. It haunts you forever. Drop dead.
I was about to ask, are we really gonna let him fall to his death? Ugh, God, not that again!
You can confess, or you can meet the pavement.
Nance and everyone involved are in jail. Maya's set free, all in all, not a bad day.
Yeah, except for the part where I have to come up with a new identity. So much for my future in the corporate world.
It's okay, I don't think that would fit you very much anyway.
I guess not. Can't change my whole life.
You moved it all back.
Yeah. It's all shoved in the corner. It's kind of hard for people to see.
You can laugh at me all you want, but I am serious.
Oh, doesn't work out.
Is everyone all right?
Yeah, I think so.
Are you okay?
The moment.
Sorry?
I wasn't supposed to stop the earthquake. I was supposed to be here for it.
Oh, my God.
How'd you know?
I told you. I'm psychic.
Okay, well, this was episode 3, I'm not really sure, I don't know, I can't say that I thought it was, like, a good episode or something. I'm not sure, like, okay, I guess. I had more fun watching other Charmed episodes, I would say. I just wasn't really that interested in the storyline. I don't know, I just didn't find the storyline that interesting and the enemy. I mean, yeah, sure, it was creepy. The actor was great at building some very messed up faces and the eyes and ooh. Like, yeah, he did a great job of being a creep. But that's about it. I just didn't find it interesting. A guy who is upset because he is scared of getting older and then, you know, totally loses it when, you know, His girlfriend leaves him for a younger guy, and then what? I don't know. It wasn't really interesting to me. I liked seeing, you know, Piper going on a job interview, and even being able, you know, to leave a good impression. I'm not sure that would work in real life if you're gonna admit that you're really not that enthusiastic, but at least, I mean, she explained why, and I can understand. I understand that she isn't too sure about what she wants to do, because that's really how I feel. I have the same feeling. A lot of people feel the same way, I believe. A lot of people are not sure, like, hey, what do I want to do? not just if you're speaking about jobs, but what do I want to do? What is going to be my next step? Is what I'm doing right for me? Like, what is my purpose? So I understand that. I kind of wish we were focusing more on that instead of, oh shit, alias I picked is someone who has to be in the world, and then we have this and that. I don't know. It wasn't really engaging to me. And Billy, I'm not too sure about her. I feel like, you know, I gave her a chance in the first episode. I know this is only episode 3, but I'm starting to get a little bit more nervous. The first episode's like, okay, she's a new character, I have to introduce her. So it's a little bit extra, you know, with the whole outfit and the weird music and whatever, okay? But now I'm starting to be a little bit like, I'm like, are we really gonna have her here as a part of the main gang? Like, the duration of the season? I don't know. Like, I'm not sure. Like, I don't hate her. But I also don't find her likable. And I don't think she's bland, because who's really bland is Phoebe's... I mean, in my opinion, again. Who's really bland, in my opinion, is Dex. So Billy at least isn't bland, but... I guess I don't really get her, but it's only episode 3, so maybe I'm being too impatient. Maybe I should give it more time? I don't know. I mean, she did have a good plan, it worked out, but like, okay, you're looking for inspiration by demons, as was it Paige who pointed that out? But I mean, it worked out. I don't know. I'm not sure what we're doing here. I kind of expected something else with this next generation thing. Maybe I expected too much. I feel like I wish they picked someone who was a little bit less sure about her abilities, who would really not only see growing in her, I guess, her powers or how she, you know, would come up with strategies, but also something who would grow on a personal level more, would get more, like, maybe... I don't know, maybe, but then a unique version, like, not totally the same, but maybe like how Piper started out. She was, at the beginning, she didn't really speak up for herself. She, well, I wouldn't say mousy, but if you compare Piper from now with season 1, I think you know what I mean. So maybe I expected someone more like that, who we could see, like, getting a confidence boost over time. But here we have this character who is already good at, like, almost everything, basically. And I guess her only downfall is that she is overconfident. I don't know, it's just not really that interesting to me. I don't know. But again, maybe I'm just being too impatient. I don't know. Just sharing what I think now. So, it's kind of weird, this whole dynamic. You know, instead of just the 3 of them, now we have this character who I thought you would teach, but instead she's kind of doing her own research. She's learning from their books and stuff, but I don't know. I didn't expect them to really be like in a classical, to say, class setting, but I don't know. Maybe we're going to see more of that. Yeah, and Dex and Phoebe. That's also, like, Dex is just, at the moment, very bland. I'm really missing Drake. I'm really missing Drake, to be honest. I really wish she could have stayed with Drake. This Dex... I mean, I like the actor's character in Sex and the City, but based just on this show, I'm like, okay, I don't know, there's just not that much. Like, he's a big fan of Phoebe, he really likes Phoebe, the girl he's talking to right now, who is Phoebe, but doesn't know, really reminds him of Phoebe. Phoebe makes him smile, Phoebe says weird things, but he isn't creeped out. He makes art. He made sure that she got a job. Oh yeah, did I say that he loves art? I don't know. It's just... I don't know. It's just the whole... I guess It was a fun, shocking moment. Like, oh my god, a fish of a future husband. But now I'm like, where do we go from here? Are we really gonna see this whole love story until they're gonna get married? Like, just in this season? I mean, this is the final season, so... I don't know. Again, it's only episode 3. This is just, I guess, my episode 3 rant. I don't know how I'm gonna feel about all this, like, around episode 10 or something, okay? I'm very much aware that I'm just starting, alright? I'm just thinking out loud, I guess. So, it was like, episode. I'm curious towards what the next episode will be like. I guess that's pretty much it. Well, thanks for watching. Bye.